How did you get into this business?
Well, it was actually my own clients who got me interested in this business. They called me in 2009, the summer and fall of 2009. The Obama administration, through their what's now known as the Ogden Memo, came out and said they wouldn't interfere with businesses that complied with state law for medical marijuana. And they would call me and say, hey, these guys want to rent my warehouse. They want to grow marijuana. Or my real estate or construction business has failed because of the Great Recession. I'm going to open a dispensary. And they asked me to look into it. So I was doing diligence for my clients, which brought me into contact with what I call the marijuana lawyers in Denver. And they said, we have so many clients for you right now. And that sounded good in the middle of the Great Recession. But I was still reluctant, and so I flew out to Oakland, California in November of 2009. I got to meet with some of the top lawyers and accountants, including Hank Levy, who's now one of my business partners. And Hank said to me something very important. He said, Jim, in the 17 years we've had legal medical marijuana in California, no CPAs have been sanctioned for helping this industry. And after some further due diligence, I came back to Denver and I told the lawyers, I said, yeah, I'll do it. And my phone's been ringing ever since. And today I have over 100 marijuana clients, dispensaries and growers in the Denver, Boulder area, but also all over Colorado and all over the United States. Now that we have Illinois and Nevada, New Jersey, I have clients in New York now. I helped just recently with some New York applications. And it's just been a very fascinating business. And politically, I've always believed marijuana should be legal. So I was glad to play my part.